ओम गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान शृण्वन्नुतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ओम डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी आर ऑन दिस श्लोक, वी हैव जस्ट कंप्लीटेड दिस श्लोक नंबर 18, दट इज नैव तस्य कृतेनार्थो न कृतेनेह कश्चन न चास्य सर्वभूतेषु कश्चिदर्थव्यपाश्रयः। सो द टू श्लोकास डिस्क्राइब द पोजिशन ऑफ ए ज्ञानी। वी आर एक्चुअली इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ कर्मयोग, बट देन आफ्टर डिस्क्राइबिंग कर्मयोग एंड आफ्टर डिस्क्राइबिंग यज्ञ about how this concept of yajna is nothing but karma yoga, then Krishna made a brief pause to tell about the level of that jnananishta, and then told Arjuna, he points out to Arjuna that you are not in that level. What is that thing? Sarvatas samplutodaka sthaniye samyak darshane navartase, that is you are not at that level where that samyak darshana sthaniya, that is you are not in that level where you are seeing Brahman everywhere. Samyak darshana is, that is proper vision, that is seeing Brahman everywhere. Sarvatas samplutodaka sthaniya, we refer to that huge lake, water body, and then where Vedas become irrelevant, not irrelevant, Vedas, he outgrows Vedas in a way. So Vedas become, from his point of view, they become irrelevant, because he goes beyond the text, he goes beyond the Veda. So that is, you are not at that level. So you have to come down and then you have to realize your situation and then perform action. So that is what he is going to say in this 19th shloka. So let us see this. Yata evam tasma, yata evam means because of this. Let us read this shloka. Tasma dasaktas satatam. कार्यं कर्म समाचर असक्तो ह्याचरन् कर्म परमाप्नोति पुरुषः। ओके, तस्मात् मीन्स् देयरफॉर, वेयरफॉर, बिकॉज यू आर नॉट क्वालिफाइड फॉर दैट ज्ञाननिष्ठ, बिकॉज यू डोंट हैव दैट एलिजिबिलिटी, देयरफॉर सततम् कार्यं कर्म समाचर। सततम् मीन्स् ऑलवेज, कार्यम कर्म, कार्यम कर्म मीन्स वाट एवर हैज़ टू बी डन, कार्यम इज समथिंग विच हैज़ टू बी डन, कार्यम यूजुअली वी मीन एनी वर्क वी मीन कार्यम, कार्यम एक्चुअली द स्ट्रिक्ट मीनिंग ऑफ कार्यम इज समथिंग विच हैज़ टू बी डन, इट इज फ्रॉम द क्रू धातु कार्यम, दट इज इट हैज़ टू बी डन। सो कार्यम कर्म समथिंग विच हैज़ बीन प्रिस्क्राइब्ड फॉर यू, दट इज द नित्य कर्म प्लस whatever is be prescribed for you by virtue of your position in the society. Every man has got a stature in society, every man has got a place, he has got a role in society. Particularly in olden days, according to this varna ashrama dharma, everybody had a particular place. So according to your place, there is a dharma which is prescribed for you. You are a kshatriya, so there is a dharma which is prescribed for you. So karyam karma is that kshatriya dharma, it you have to do it, some achara, samyak achara. And then how, in what manner? Asaktah, tasmad asaktah satatam karyam karma samachara. Each word has some significance here. Asaktah means without any sort of attachment to that. Sakti is attachment. Sangha, you know what is sangha? Sangha is attachment. Not sangha. Sangha means group. Sangha, ordinary ga, without aspirate. So that is sangha means attachment. The state of having an attachment is called sakti. Sakti, the state of being attached to something. Asakti means without having that, without being in that state of attachment. Na plus sakti becomes asakti. That is, tasmad asaktaha satatam, satatam, always. Because a person cannot keep quiet even for a minute. That is what we saw earlier. Nahi kaschit chanam api jatu tishtapya karma krutte. So, in that manner, because you are not qualified for jnananishtha, in a very dispassionate, and then in a very dispassionate manner, karyam karma samachara. Samachara means sam plus achara samachara. Sam is an upasarga. Upasarga means a prefix. Sam, the meaning of sam is samyak, in a proper manner. It is not as though, suppose you say, you do this in a very dispassionate manner. Obviously, you lose interest in that. You have interest only when you have a personal gain, personal benefit and what not. So, when you say, when somebody says, you do this without raga, dvesha, you do this in a very, very dispassionate way, then maybe there can be a tendency to do it in a very, very haphazard manner, in a very, very, say, ritualistic manner, in a rather totally uninterested or a casual manner. So, he says, samachara, you do it with all activeness, with full vigor, with all interest and zeal. So, that is what he says. Asakto hyachara, because even when you do a karma, without expecting the fruit of action, the fruit will definitely follow. It is not as though you are denying the fruit. You are only told, don't have attachment for that. You will definitely get the fruit. It is not as though every action will give you some result. That result, you please take that result, accept that result. As again, something with an Ishwararpana Buddhi, you accept it. But then, don't cling to that. So, that is the meaning of Karma Yoga. It does not mean that you do some selfless action and then you don't expect any result, you don't receive the result also. You get the result, you happily enjoy the result, but then you will not be gloating on that. You will not be gloating in it rather. Asakto hi acharan, the second line, asaktaha hi acharan karma param apnoti purushaha. Asaktaha, in such manner, in such a dispassionate, disinterested manner, not uninterested but disinterested manner, asakta he means yasmat, because even such a person will get all the benefit. This, the purport of this shloka is that karma yoga is not a hindrance to jnana. The idea of this shloka is not to say that karma yoga is leading you to jnana. We should not misinterpret this shloka by saying this karma yoga is leading you to jnana. That is not the way. Karma yoga is leading to you to a particular stage where your mind becomes qualified. And then from there you can step on, you can have a step on and then go towards Jnananishtha. So that is the purpose of this thing. And the purpose is to say that Karma Yoga is not something which is a hindrance, which is not something which is a stumbling block for Jnana. You perform Karma Yoga and then you get some, you attain what is that? Chitta Shuddhi. So that is the meaning here. He, that is Yasmat, Asaktaha Acharan Karma. So in a dispassionate manner, if you are doing that karma, Param apunoti purushaha. Param means paramam purushartham. Param, you know, what is param? Param is supreme. Param means that param purushartham, that supreme goal. That is apunoti. Apunoti means attains. Who? Purushaha. Purusha means any person. Any person attains by performing karma in a very, very dispassionate manner, without having some attachment or clinging to that, and then doing whatever is assigned to him, whatever assigned duty is there, you do it in a very active manner. So that is the meaning of that. Let us see Shankaracharya's Bhashyam. Yasmacha yatayev mataha tasmaditi. Tasmat asaktaha sangavarjitaha satatam sarvada karyam kartavyam nityam karma samachara nirvartaya.
Samachara nirvartaya.
Tasmat, therefore, asaktaha. Asaktaha means sangavarjitaha. Without having attachment or sangha. Satatam means sarvada, always. Karyam karma. What is this karyam karma? He is making a division. That is kartavyam plus nityam karma. Kartavyam karma is there by virtue of you being in a particular social plane, and then there is also a nitya karma which is prescribed for everybody. There is a nitya karma, like we said, every day we are talking about that nitya karma, that is Sandhya Vandana, Agnihotra, and say this Pancha Yajnas, that is feeding the poor and then feeding the animals and all these things, Bhuta Yajna and what not. So, all these things, they are there, nitya karma. In addition to that nitya karma, there is an assigned karma for a particular person of a particular, he is in a particular slot in society. So, according to that slot, there is a dharma. So, you have to perform that dharma. Karma samachara nirvartaya. Sam plus achara, samachara, I explained. Nirvartaya, that is, you perform you do it, you execute. Nirvartaya actually means you execute. Then asaktaha hi yasmat,
asaktaha hi yasmat,
samacharan,
samacharan,
ishwarartham karma kurvan,
ishwarartham karma kurvan,
moksham aapnoti purushaha,
moksham aapnoti purushaha,
sattva shuddhi dwarena ityarthaha,
sattva shuddhi dwarena ityarthaha.
So here Shankaracharya is explaining the meaning of samachara also. Samacharan means ishwarartham karma kurvan. Ishwara, that is, what is that Ishwara? That cosmic order. Ishwara, you should not say mean only some deity and then you are doing all these things for a particular deity. It is not like that. Ishwarartham means Ishwararpana Buddhi, means you are doing it for the cosmic well-being, for the cosmic order, for the world order, let us say, as an order from the Lord, as something which is a you are following a universal principle. We have seen what is that yajna. Yajna is that universal principle of cooperative action. So all that thing has to, is meant by the word Ishwara. Not as though one person Ishwara and you are visualizing a god form and then you are doing worship. And it is not like that. So Ishwara arpana buddhya karma kurvan, asaktahi esmat samacharan ishwarartham karma kurvan, moksham apunoti purushaha. Moksham apunoti, that is, he is specifically mentioning moksham he attains, not merely by karma. By what is that process? Sattva shuddhi dwarena ityartha. Sattva shuddhi dwarena, that is, the karma is supposed to give you some purity of mind. So the question is whether karma has brought about some amount of transformation in you or not. If the question has brought about, if the say karma has brought about some transformation in you, then it has worked properly. If it has not brought about any transformation in us, then obviously it has not worked on us. So that is supposed to be the test. That is a sort of test. Like we say in English, the proof of the pudding is in the eating. So if you are doing a karma, if you are on a karma marga, if you are on this path of karma, the test is whether you have this purity of mind. And we can see people all around us. A person who is a highly religious man, whether he is having a pure mind or not. A highly religious man is supposed to overcome all his anger, greed and whatnot. You should also become a real man with a lot of purity and then without any hatred for others. So on the other hand, religion can also make a man a fanatic. Religion can make a man very, very intolerant of others. In fact, that is what we see. Religious intolerance is the highest thing which we see. A highly religious man can be a highly intolerant man. So that is why this clash of civilizations. There is a wonderful book which came around 10 years ago by one gentleman called Huntington, Samuel Huntington. Have you heard that name? There is a person called Samuel Huntington who wrote a book, The Clash of Civilizations. How civilizations have been quarreling. Civilization means only religion. Civilization is built up around a religion. Religion is a particular belief system saying that this is the particular god, this is the god, and then this is the manner in which he functions. So around that religion, some sort of civilization is built up. So the clash of civilization, it basically refers to the type of clash which is going on in the Western society between the Western countries and also these Arabian countries. So which is right from the 10th century in the form of crusades and whatnot, and still continuing. And unfortunately, both the fellows are falling on us, very, very poor India, which is the only pluralistic, which is the only remaining, let us say, which is the only surviving pluralistic culture. By the word pluralistic, what I mean is, we are the only people who say that you visualize God in any God form. Because we are developed under that philosophy of Upanishads. Upanishads say, whatever you say about religion is something very limited. Religion is something which is a belief system, which tells you this is the way. But this is not the only way. You visualize God in any form. You visualize God, manas as Brahma. You visualize, Hridaya is Brahma. You visualize some Surya as Brahma, you visualize a small rock as Vishnu. So something like that, you visualize in any form and then you attain that Chitta Shuddhi. The purpose of religion is to make you having a pure mind and not to become fanatical to that. So religion can make a man, religion can turn a man into a very dangerous person. So that should not happen. So because unfortunately the attack is on us, which is the only say society or which is the only civilization which says that you have any type of God. You have so that is why our people said, I was telling about Shankaracharya. Shankaracharya did not go about destroying religions. Shankaracharya wanted to harmonize. In fact, he is called Shanmata Sthapakacharya. I think I told you. He is called a person who has established six systems. He has not newly discovered them. They were already there. Several at Shankara, during Shankaracharya's time, around 60 to 70 odd systems were there. All types of crude, violent systems, and then all these Jantu Bali and what not, all types of sacrifices and all those things. So Shankaracharya examined all this, moved from Kerala to Kashmir and all over the country he moved, and then discussed with so many scholars, discussed and argued with so many scholars, and then he only preserved those. He said only these things let us standardize. He did some sort of standardization and then harmonization. So in this process of standardization, he said, okay, you worship in various places of the country, because India was quite vast. In different parts of the country, different gods were being worshipped. So what has to be done? So he has to give a meaning to that. He has to give a meaning to that and say, yes, you worship this as Brahman. You worship this as Supreme Brahman. You worship this as Supreme Brahman. Whatever you are worshipping, you worship it as Supreme Brahman. So that is what he said, and that is why he is called Shanmata Sthapakacharya. So Sauram, Shakteyam, Vaishnavam, Ganapatyam. So like that, then again in another part, Shanmukha was there. So like that, all types of Shakti is there. So all these things, they are acceptable. So you worship, but then he removed certain bad practices, certain violent practices from religion. So our approach was to harmonize. So that unfortunately is the situation. Anyway, religion is supposed to give you purity of mind. That is the question here, that litmus test, or the proof of the pudding is in the eating, means that is the test. The basic thing you have to see in a person is whether the person is having a tolerant approach and a very broad-minded approach, or whether he is having a fanatical approach. So that is at a different level. In a modern context, if we want to translate this shloka, in very, very modern terms, if we want to interpret this shloka, we have to tell all this. But here it means, a person sattva shuddhi dvarena mokshamapnoti purushaha sattva shuddhi dvarena. His antahkarana becomes pure. So and in that process, he becomes eligible for that jnana path. So that is the meaning. The next shloka, yasmaccha. Next shloka, karmanaiva hi samsiddhim. Asthita janakadayah. Lokasangrahameva api. Sampashyan kartumarhasi. So here Lord Krishna is giving some examples, because Arjuna might think that, okay, this gentleman is just goading me on to some sort of nishkama karma, but where is the authority? So Krishna says, this is not something new which I am telling. This has been there. This is our, this is what is the meaning of the Veda. This is the tradition of this Veda. And then, karmanaiva hi samsiddhim asthita janakadayah. In olden days also, that is, then we have to now take that even this King Janaka and all these people are much older to this particular period. That is, this is Dwapara Yuga, according to our calculation. This is Mahabharatam occurred at the end of the Dwapara Yuga. And then much before is that Treta Yuga, where Rama and Janaka and all those people lived. Janaka, and then much before that in Krita Yuga, there are so many kings. All these Mandhata and all these kings were there in that Krita Yuga. And then there are other kings like Prahlada, Ambarisha and all these people. So we don't exactly know in what yuga they were there, but then they are all historical characters, slightly transformed into mythological characters. they are not even in mythology, they are there actually in Mahabharata. Mahabharata, you get all these stories, particularly in this Vanaparva. Vanaparva is the portion in Mahabharata where these Pandavas are in exile. They are in the forest for how many years? 12 years. Yeah, they are there for 12 years. And during those 12 years, different sages go to them and then tell them some stories. somebody goes and tells some story. They see the plight of Yudhishthira, they see the plight of, the pitiable plight of Draupadi, and then they say, so that it is something like a psychological counseling. You see, in this great world, in this long process of human history, there are so many great kings who have suffered like you. So you please tolerate this thing for a while, and then you will come back, and then you will get back your kingdom. So they were giving them some courage, they were giving them some hope. So it is a type of psychological counseling which all these rishis and munis were doing, if we just see the Vanaparva. So there you get the stories of all these people. In fact, Ramayana is contained in a few chapters in Vanaparva. The whole of Ramayana is contained in a few chapters in Vanaparva. Then again, similarly, the Satya Harishchandra's story, that again is a very long passage that is there. Then Nala Upakhyana, the story of the king Nala, how he suffered underwent a lot of suffering, and then how he again came back to kingdom. And very many people who were highly virtuous, because of their virtuous conduct, they got into some problems. It is not because of their bad conduct. It is because of their highly virtuous and principled conduct, they got into some problems. And then they got back. They got back their kingdom. They lived happily. So all those stories, they were told to this Pandavas when they were in the forest. So like that, here again, Janaka, the story of Janaka. Janaka Adayaha means what, any names given in this? Janakadinam. Okay. There, of course, there's no need for any names. This Janaka, Ashwapati, King Prahlada, and so many other people who were renowned kings, but at the same time, they were gyanis. Being a king and being a gyani, there is no contradiction. They were called Rajarshi. The Raja and Rishi. Because in olden days, the syllabus for the kings included, I think I told you in the beginning, the syllabus of the kings included Anvikshaki, Trayi, Varta, Dandanitischa, Shashwati. Anvikshaki, this is from a line from a Kamandaka Niti Shastra. It is quoted actually in Mallinatha Suri's commentary on Raghuvamsha. So, in these commentaries, we come across so many small quotations from some books which are not available now. This Kamandaka Niti Shastram, I am not sure whether it is available now, but it is from that Niti Shastra. Anvikshaki means logic. King is supposed to know what is a logical argument and what is an illogical argument. Somebody should not come and fool him. So, a king is supposed to learn logic. Then, Trayi means Veda. This Rik, Sama, Yajus, these three, originally only these three were considered as Vedas. Subsequently, Atharvana Veda also was added. So, okay, this Trayi, why? This Trayi includes not only this ritual portion, but also the philosophical portion, that is the Upanishadic portion. So, that means a person who is supposed to know what is the religion at a lower level and what is philosophy at a higher level. Because religion and Vedanta, both are blended in such a way that a man will undergo first this discipline called ritual, this discipline called religion, and then goes beyond religion to attain his own self-knowledge. So that is the scheme. So a king, simply because he is a king, he is not forbidden from Brahmajnana. one thing is not there for him, that is he cannot become a sannyasi. Sannyasa is something which is only prescribed for a Brahmin, because a Brahmin, he is not supposed to accumulate wealth, he is not supposed to be greedy. So, he is supposed to dedicate himself for the world. So, only a Brahmin was entitled to be a sannyasi. But for others, Jnananishta is there. He can become a Jnani. So, in fact, Nilakanta Vyakhya, it is very clearly given. Kshatriyasya sannyase adhikaro nasti iti chet, Bharata Rushi, Rushabhadi, Rushabhadi vad, Vikshepa, Karmatyaga Matre Ahikarat Vartike. Then he quotes one quotation from one Vartika, where he says Kshatriya and also all others, they have got Adhikara, they are entitled for Brahmajnana. It is not as though Brahman alone is entitled for Brahmajnana. Brahman is entitled only for Sannyasa. Brahmajnana is equal to all. So that is one point which we have to see. But anyway, Janakadayaha, I was telling about that, Janaka and so many other kings, this Rajarshi. Anvikshaki trayi, yeah, I missed that line. Anvikshaki trayi, trayi means Veda. Varta, Varta means commerce. So a king, a ruler, he is supposed to have some knowledge in trade and commerce. Then Dandaniti. Dandanitischa Shashvati. What is Dandaniti? Criminal law. Not only criminal law, civil and criminal law. The criminal jurisprudence, let us say. So he should know whom to punish and whom not to punish. So a king was trained, not only a king, all the people in the kingly clan, in fact all the Kshatriyas, this was the syllabus for all the Kshatriyas in olden days. So like that, this Janakadayaha, they were Rajarshis. And in fact Raja and Rishi, in fact what Plato calls a philosopher king, Plato, he wrote a book called Republic. There he visualizes a situation where the kingdom is ruled by a philosopher king. So something, such thing existed in India in the form of this Janaka, Rishabha and so many other people. So this is Janakadayaha, Karmana eva samsiddhim asthitaha. Let us see this line. Karmana eva is Karmana plus eva becomes Karmana eva. Karmana eva means along with karma, through the process of karma only. It is not as though karma is a burden on you. Karma along with karma or through the process of karma only, samsiddhim asthitaha. Samsiddhi means that sam plus siddhi, that ultimate attainment, that supreme attainment. Whatever is that supreme attainment, what is that supreme attainment, that is moksha. Asthitaha means they attain. Janakadayaha, Janaka Adi, that is Janaka, Ashwapati, he gives some name, Bharata, Rushabha. Some other names of King Bharata, King Rushabha, all these things. These names we get in Mahabharata and also in Bhagavata also we get the names of so many kings. So all these people, then they attain that supreme goal. Then, Loka Sangraham eva api sampashyan kartum arhasi. Loka Sangraham eva api sampashyan kartum arhasi. So, Loka Sangraham eva, at least seeing this Loka Sangraha, or at least from the point of view of Loka Sangraha. Loka Sangraham Sampashyan means at least keeping that in mind. Sampashyan means seeing it. It is not exactly seeing here. It is not as though you are seeing physically. Keeping it in view. Sampashyan means keeping it in view. Keeping in view this Loka Sangraha, you are supposed to do your karma. Kartum arhasi. That is, you are supposed to do your karma. What is this Loka Sangraha? This Loka Sangraha is a very beautiful term used in Gita. Graha, Grahanam, sam plus Graha is Sangraha. Grahanam is catching hold of something, grabbing something, catching hold. Grubhanati, grab and grahana and grubhanati, and grab, English grab, they are related. So Grahanam is catching, collecting. Sangraha is collecting something. Collecting some articles, collecting something, that is called Sangraha. Loka Sangraha is collecting people together, keeping people united, and then keeping, that means, ensuring some sort of social order. So that is what is Loka Sangraha, ensuring some sort of social order, bringing people together, collecting people together. So that is what is Loka Sangraha. Loka Sangraham eva api sampashyan kartum arhasi. So that is, Arjuna is ordered to do, or it is enjoined on him that he as a king, he is a Kshatriya king, he is supposed to see that social order prevails. He is supposed to ensure that social unity or social defense, as we call it. So our social defense or social order, in any manner you want, whatever you want to say. So that is that. In fact, this Loka Sangraha is one topic which is a very recurrent theme in Mahabharata. A person who is supposed to do a job, he has to jolly well do that. He cannot abdicate it. Abdication is not the answer. In fact, the people who abdicate, they can be punished. They will also perish in that scheme of dharma, in the overall scheme of dharma. The people who abdicate their karma, they also perish. They perish and then they have a miserable end. That is what in fact Mahabharata says. In fact, when Krishna, we know the scene of Krishna Rayabharam. You know Krishna Rayabharam? Krishna goes to the court of these Kauravas on behalf of Pandavas just to plead that, okay, you please, you give them what is due to them. Or if you are so adamant and if you do not want to give at least even what is due to them, at least give them five villages, so that these five brothers, they can survive and they can sustain and live in an honorable manner. So that was the message. So at that time, so he refers to what has happened to Pandavas, and then how Pandavas suffered at the hands of these Kauravas, and what exactly happened in the court of Dhritarashtra, and when that Dushasana dragged and tried to disrobe this Draupadi. So all those things he refers, and while referring to that, there is a very beautiful passage, a few shlokas are there, where he refers to this dharma, and then the inability of the competent people, or the silence of the majority, as we call it now. Now we talk about the silence of the intelligentsia, the silence of intellectuals. So that is what Krishna refers when he says, yatra dharmo hyadharmena satyam yatra anrutena cha hanyate prekshamananam hatastatra sabhasadaha. He refers to this Bhishma, Drona and all those Kaurava elders who are there in that Kaurava court, who were just sitting silent when Dushasana was trying to disrobe Draupadi. Dushasana is doing an unlawful act, and then he is doing such an outrageous act, whereas all these people who are competent to intervene, the anger of Krishna is those who are competent to intervene, those who are wise and also competent to intervene, these people are not intervening. So he says all those people also will perish. So that is what is the structure of dharma. Yatra dharmaha adharmena, dharma when it is being battered by adharma, satyam yatra anrutena cha, when truth is being assailed by untruth. In fact, a person should have the boldness to tell truth. In fact, if people lose the capacity to tell truth, then they become more and more weak, like we see in the governments now. That is, the governments become more and more, they become highly getting into a sort of weak position, a sort of capitulating position, where they are not able to speak facts to people, they are not able to govern. So that sort of situation arises. Yatra satyam yatra anrutena cha hanyate prekshamananam hatastatra sabhasadaha. All these sabhasadaha, all these people all the elders who are there sitting in that sabha, they will also hataha, they will also get beaten. So in this manner, there are a few shlokas there in the same vein. In Mahabharata, the constant theme, the recurring theme is about establishment of dharma, and a person who is competent to do a thing has to jolly well do, otherwise he will be punished. He will also get destroyed, rather. He will get not punished by anybody, but he will get destroyed in the system. That is the overall scheme of dharma. A person who is silent, suppose something unjust is happening, you are capable of intervening and you are not intervening, then that means you will also be sucked into the system, you will also get destroyed in that process. So that is what is it. So lokasangraham eva api sampashyan kartum arhasi. So that is the meaning. So let us see Shankaracharya's lines. Karmanaiva hi yasmat
पूर्वे
क्षत्रियाः विद्वांसः संसिद्धिं मोक्षं गन्तुम् आस्थिताः प्रवृत्ताः जनकादयः जनक अश्वपति प्रभृतयः. सो कर्मणा एव, that is along with karma only. Karma is not a hindrance or a burden to you. He means yasmat, because purve kshatriyah vidvamsah. So he is also very specifically mentioning that they were also gyanis. Vidvamsa means not merely some scholars, not some scholar in history or something else. He is a gyani. So these people who are gyanis, they were philosopher kings, they are called rajarshis. So those people, samsiddhim, moksham, sam plus siddhi, samsiddhi, that is moksham, gantum asthitaha pravruttaha. So they were on their way. Gantum asthitaha means they were actually proceeding towards that. Gantum asthitaha means, gantum means in order to go, gantum. Gantum pravruttaha, that is they were prepared to go, they were on that path, they were moving on that path. So that is it. Moksham samsiddhim gantum asthitaha pravruttaha. So through this process only, through the process of karma only, they were going towards this moksha marga. That is the meaning. देन हू आर दे जनकादयः जनक अश्वपति प्रभृतयः जनक अश्वपति इज अनदर किंग हू इज मेंशनड इन से महाभारत सो ऑल दीज पीपल दे आर द चैप्स हू दे आर द राजर्षिस हू अटेंड मोक्ष थ्रू द प्रोसेस by not abandoning the process of karma, not directly through the process of karma, we should not make that mistake, not abandoning the path of karma. Then,
yadi te,
prapta samyak darshanaha, tato loka sangrahartham, prarabdha karmatvat,
karmana sahiva,
asanyasyaiva karma. Samsiddhim asthitah ityarthah. Okay, yadi te, this discussion was there earlier also, somewhere in 11th shloka of say the second chapter, Ashochyan and Vashochastvam. Under that, there was again another reference to these people, this Janaka and others. There were two alternatives mentioned there. Where the question was whether Janaka was a Samyak Darshana, whether he had Samyak Darshana or whether they did not have. So the answer is, if they were really Jnanis, they were performing this karma because of the Prarabdha. Prarabdha means that which has already commenced. Prarabdha we should not take in a negative sense. In Telugu, we use it in a very negative sense. Prarabdha means that which has already commenced. Because the man is born as a Kshatriya, because the man is born as a ruler, he is supposed to continue that duty, his dharma as a ruler. So that is what is the Prarabdha Karma. So though they were Jnanis, they performed their Prarabdha Karma. So we have to interpret in that manner, if they were Jnanis. If they were not Jnanis, then how have you to interpret? Suppose they were not Jnanis, they were performing this karma as a karma yoga, and then attained Chitta Shuddhi, and then attained Moksha. So, in two manners we have to interpret, that is what Shankaracharya is saying here. Yadi te prapta samyak darshanaha, that is, if they have already attained this samyak darshana, then in that condition, in that situation, lokasangrahartham prarabdha karmatvat, lokasangrahartham, the one motive is lokasangrahartham, because it is their job to ensure social order, lokasangrahartham, then prarabdha karmatvat, because it is enjoined on them, and then it is his prarabdha karma, he can't abandon it. He can't say, a kshatriya cannot say, no, I want to become a sannyasi. Only a brahmin can become a sannyasi. A kshatriya has to do his job. In fact, it is a more difficult thing. Because a brahmin can say, okay, I am abandoning everything, and then he can go and live a virtuous life. But a king, staying in the midst of so many attractions, staying in the midst of so much of power and power structure, he is still a Jnani. It is more difficult for him. In fact, that is why Janaka and others, they are considered to be very great people in our tradition. It is very easy to seclude yourself. It is very easy to go into a forest and then have some ashram and then stay in that ashram. That is very easy. But it is very difficult. This is it's a dynamic situation. In a very, very dynamic situation, very vulnerable situation, you are maintaining your cool. So, this is a more difficult process. So, these people, atha apra loka sangrahartham prarabdha karmatvat karmana sahaiva asanyasyaiva karma. That is, by not relinquishing karma, by not renouncing karma, samsiddhim asthitaha ityarthaha, they attained that moksha. Then, the other alternative also he is saying, atha aprapta samyak darshanaha janakadayaha
तदा कर्मणा
सत्वशुद्धि साधन भूतेन
क्रमेण समसिद्धिम आस्थिता
इति व्याख्येयः श्लोकः. So as I said, the second alternative is atha, in case अप्राप्त सम्यक दर्शनाः, if they are not people who have attained that सम्यक दर्शन, then aprapta samyak darshana janakadayah, if those janaka and others are in that position, tada, in that situation, karmana sattva shuddhi sadhana bhutena, then karma is sattva shuddhi sadhanam, it is a tool, it is a strategy, sadhanam is a tool or a strategy for sattva, for what, sattva shuddhi. So in that process, kramena, ग्रेजुअली क्रमेण ग्रेजुअली संसिद्धि आस्थिताः दे अटेंड मोक्ष इति व्याख्येयः श्लोकः दिस श्लोक हैज टू बी कमेंटेड अपॉन इट हैज टू बी से एक्सप्लेन्ड लाइक दैट व्याख्येयः मीन्स इट हैज टू बी एक्सप्लेन्ड इट हैज टू बी कमेंटेड अपॉन लाइक दैट देन नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन अथ मन्यते पूर्वैरपि जनकादिभिरपि जनकादिभिरपि अजानद्भिरेव कर्तव्यं कर्मकृतं तावता न अवश्यं अन्येन कर्तव्यं सम्यग्दर्शनवता कृतार्थेन इति तथापि प्रारब्धकर्मायत्तः त्वं लोकसंग्रहमेवापि लोकस्य उन्मार्ग प्रवृत्ति निवारणं लोकसंग्रहः तमेवापि प्रयोजनं संपश्यन् कर्तुमर्हसि सो लॉर्ड कृष्णा इज एडवांसिंग अनदर आर्ग्युमेंट इन केस यू फील सपोज ही इज नॉट एबल टू सी और ही इज जस्ट गिविंग द बेनिफिट ऑफ डाउट टू अर्जुन इन केस यू फील ओके जनक एंड अदर्स दे वर नॉट ज्ञानीस दे वर अप्राप्त सम्यक दर्शना बिकॉज दे वर नॉट ज्ञानीस दे डिड कर्म बट आई एम ए ज्ञानी अर्जुन कृष्णा इज विजुअलाइजिंग द सिचुएशन अर्जुन मे फील ओके जनक एंड अदर्स दे वर अज्ञानीस एंड देन दे डिड ऑल दिस कर्म आई एम ए ज्ञानी वाई शुड आई डू कर्म सो दट इज अर्जुनास क्वेश्चन अर्जुनास एंटिसिपेटेड क्वेश्चन So that for that Krishna is saying no in spite of that even then prarabdha karmayatah tvam so the first alternative we saw above if you are a jnani there is a prarabdha karma for you you are born as a kshatriya it is your duty to say ensure this loka sangraha and for that sake you have to do your duty so that is the meaning here atha manyate means if you feel that purvairapi janakadibhi by all these ancient purvaihi means ancient all these ancient people who are the janaka etc janakadibhirapi ajanadbhi means those who were ignorant ignorant means not brahmagyanis not that they were otherwise ignorant ajanadbhi means ajanan is the word ajanadbhihi is the tritiya bahuvachanam there tratyanan ajanadbhihi by the people who are ignorant by the people who are ajnanis not brahmagyanis by those who were not brahmagyanis kartavyam karma krutam so those people they did because they were not having brahmagyana tavata by that na avashyam anyena kartavyam simply because they did tavata means simply because they did I need not follow na avashyam anyena kartavyam anyena by another man again it has to be done samyak darshanavata krutarthena by one who is having this samyak darshana and by one who is a krutartha means somebody for whom there is no further thing to be done krutartha if a jnani is a person he is a krutartha krutam artham yena sa krutartha కృత ప్లస్ అర్థ మీన్స్ కృతార్థ అర్థ మీన్స్ దట్ ఆబ్జెక్టివ్ కృతార్థ ఈస్ వన్ సంబడి హూ హెస్ ఆల్రెడీ అటైన్డ్ దట్ ఆబ్జెక్టివ్ కృతం అర్థం ఏన స కృతార్థ దట్ ఈస్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఆల్రెడీ అటైన్డ్ మోక్ష ఆల్రెడీ అటైన్డ్ జ్ఞాన్ అరాధర్ సో వై ఐ షుడ్ ఐ డూ కర్మ సో ఇఫ్ యూ థింక్ సో తథాపి మీన్స్ ఈవన్ దెన్ ప్రారబ్ధ కర్మాయత్తః త్వం యు ఆర్ ఎ ప్రారబ్ధ కర్మ ఆయత్తః You are bound by prarabdha karma. Prarabdha karma yattaha. So that is you are bound by prarabdha karma, and because of that, tvam loka sangraha meva api sampashyam. So here Shankaracharya is giving a meaning, a fairly elaborate meaning for this loka sangraha. Lokasya unmarga pravrutti nivaranam loka sangraha. This is a beautiful explanation. You can underline lokasya unmarga pravrutti nivaranam. Unmarga means రాంగ్ పాత్ లోక మీన్స్ పీపుల్ లోకస్య ఉన్మార్గ ప్రవృత్తి దట్ ఈస్ దేర్ ప్రవృత్తి ఆర్ దేర్ మూమెంట్ ఇన్ ఏ రాంగ్ పాత్ దేర్ సే ఫాలోయింగ్ ఏ రాంగ్ పాత్ నివారణం మీన్స్ టు ప్రివెంట్ दट ईज प्रिवेंटिंग पीपल फ्रॉम फॉलोइंग ए रॉन्ग पाथ ईज लोक संग्रह दट इज ए थिंग लोक संग्रह मीन्स कलेक्टिंग पीपल कीपिंग पीपल टुगेदर सीइंग दट एंश्यूरिंग दट दे डू नॉट फॉलो ए रॉन्ग पाथ दट इज उन्मार्ग प्रवृत्ति निवारण उन्मार्ग मार्ग इज नॉट ए नॉर्मल पाथ उन्मार्ग मीन्स द रॉन्ग पाथ उन्मार्ग प्रवृत्ति दट इज मूविंग इन दट रॉन्ग पाथ निवारण दट इज प्रिवेंटिंग उन्मार्ग प्रवृत्ति निवारण इज प्रिवेंटिंग ऑल दिस द सोसाइटी फ्रॉम गोइंग इन ए रॉन्ग पाथ सो दट इज लोकसंग्रह लोकसंग्रहमेवापि कीपिंग दट प्रयोजनम कीपिंग दट ऑब्जेक्टिव इन माइंड प्रयोजनम इज ऑब्जेक्टिव दट से वट यू कॉल प्रयोजनम प्रयोजनम इज दट रिजल्ट that objective, that benefit, let us say, keeping that benefit in mind, sampashyan means by seeing it properly, by keeping it in mind, kartum arhasi, you have to do your karma, so that is it. Lokasangraham, kaha kartum arhati, katham cha, ityuchyate, so lokasangraha kaha kartum arhati, katham cha. That is, who has to do this lokasangraham and then in what manner? Katham cha means in what manner? Kaha kartum ichyati, who does this lokasangraha? So then this shloka, yad yad iti. Let us read this shloka. Yad yad acharati shreshtaha.
Yad yad acharati shreshtaha.
Tatta deveta rojanaha.
Tatta deveta rojanaha.
Sayat pramanam kurute.
Sayat pramanam kurute.
Lokastadanu vartate. Okay, here, yat yad acharati shreshtha. This shreshtha is what? Shreshtha is somebody who is there, who is in the topmost position in a society. Shreshtha, who is in a top portion, they are the people who are the elite in the society, let us say. He is the top man in the society. Shreshtha, one who is considered great in the society. That person, yad yad acharati. Whatever he does, yat means whatever. Acharati means in whatever manner he conducts himself. Acharam, achara is what is achara? Basically conduct. Acharati means the way he conducts himself. Yat yat acharati shreshtaha, in whatsoever manner that shreshta, that great man conducts himself. Tattadeva itaro janaha, tattadeva, in the same manner, itaraha janaha. Tat eva itara janaha. Tattadeva itaro janaha. We have to split like that. Tat plus eva plus itaraha plus janaha. Tattadeva itaro janaha. In the same manner, the other man will follow. It is used in the singular thing. Yadya dacharati shreshtaha. Whatever is great man does, the other person follows. Then sa yat pramanam kurute. Other man means everybody. Here, itaro janahami refers to everybody, not only to one person. Sa yat pramanam kurute. Saha means that shreshtha, that great man. Yat pramanam kurute. Whatever he maintains as a standard, or whatever he say considers a standard, or whatever behavior he establishes. So that is taken as a standard. Lokaha tat anuvartate. Lokaha means everybody in the society. Tat anuvartate. Anuvartate means follows. Anuvartanam. Vartanam means going. Anuvartanam means following. Following somebody. Anu plus vartanam. Anuvartanam is following. So that is the general overall meaning of the shloka. Let us see the bhashyam. Yad yad.
Karma acharati.
Yeshu.
Shreshtaha.
Pradhanabhutaha.
Tattadeva karma.
Acharati. Itaraha.
Anyo janaha.
Tad anugataha. Kincha. Shreshtaha yat pramanam kurute. Laukikam vaidikam va. Lokaha. Tad anuvartate. Tadeva.
Pramani karoti ityartha.
So in a very simple manner he has explained. So this shloka is telling about a sort of the ideal conduct of great persons, and then these great persons who become sort of role models for others, and then because the loka, all the people, they have got a tendency to imitate the greater people. So we are all following that, we imitate whoever is the greater person. सो दट इज सिचुएशन हियर यद यद आचरति यत यत कर्म आचरति येषु येषु श्रेष्ठः येषु येषु दट इज इन वाट एवर मैनर इन वाट एवर फील्ड ही इज ए ग्रेट पर्सन इन वाट एवर फील्ड ही इज ए ग्रेट पर्सन येषु येषु मीन्स येषु यः मीन्स हू एवर ए पर्सन हू येषु इज सप्तमी बहुवचनम येषु दट इज इन वाट एवर इन विच एवर ग्रूप लेट अस से ए श्रेष्ठ ए ग्रेट मैन प्रधानभूतः प्रधानभूतः मीन्स इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट मैन इन दट पर्टिक्युलर ग्रूप तत्तदेव कर्म आचरति द सेम कर्म इज बीइंग इज फॉलोड बाय ऑल अदर्स अन्यः जनः तद अनुगतः अनुगत इज ए फॉलोयर हुएवर इज देयर द अनुगत हुएवर इज द फॉलोयर ही टेक्स ही से फॉलोज दट थिंग देन स यत् प्रमाणं कुरुते देन द नेक्स्ट लाइन इज किंच मोरोवर किंच मीन्स मोरोवर श्रेष्ठः यत् प्रमाणं कुरुते दिस श्रेष्ठ श्रेष्ठ मीन्स द ग्रेट मैन यत् प्रमाणं कुरुते वाट एवर स्टैंडर्ड ही सेट्स वाट एवर स्टैंडर्ड ही सेट्स देन लौकिकं वैदिकं वा वेदर इट इज इन दि से टेम्पोरल फील्ड वेदर इट इज ए लौकिक कर्म आर वेदर इट इज इन द वैदिक फील्ड दट मीन्स वेदर इट इज इन लोक व्यवहार लौकिक मीन्स इन लोक व्यवहार दट इज इन द नॉर्मल डे टू डे ट्रांसाक्शन इन नॉर्मल डे टू डे ट्रांसाक्शन हाउ ही बिहेव्स एंड देन इन अदर से रिचुअल्स एंड ऑल दिस वैदिक थिंग्स इन वट एवर मे वे ही बिहेव्स सो दिस अदर पीपल दे फॉलो सो दिस इज वन थिंग विच वी हैव टू सी सो ऑल द पीपल बेसिकली we follow the great people that is the say the order of, that is actually the nature that is the nature of the people in fact in I am reminded of one shloka from Mahabharata that is I think I told you mahajano yena gatasya pantha so the common man he tends to follow the path taken by the great men so we talk of ramayana what is ramayana rama plus ayanam ramayanam That is the path taken by Rama, the code of conduct, the behavior, the way Rama conducted himself. That is what is Ramayanam. The meaning of Ramayanam is the path of Rama, Ramayanam. So Mahajano yena gatasya pantha. In fact, that shloka is from Yakshaprashnas in Mahabharata, where Dharmaraja goes and then he encounters a question: What is the dharma? Dharma is something which is in your own conscience, he says. तर्कः अप्रतिष्ठः तर्कोप्रतिष्ठः श्रुतयो विभिन्नः तर्क मीन्स ऑल दीस आर्ग्युमेंट्स देर इज नो एंड टू दीस आर्ग्युमेंट्स तर्कः अप्रतिष्ठः देन व्हाट इज द ट्रूथ व्हाट इज द रियलिटी व्हाट इज द नेचर ऑफ गॉड पीपल कीप ऑन आर्ग्यूइंग एंड देन देर इज नो एंड टू दैट सो दैट इज व्हाई ही सेड तर्कः अप्रतिष्ठः देर इज नो एंड टू दैट श्रुतयो विभिन्नः श्रुतयः दैट इज एवरीबडी सेज दिस इज माय स्टैंडर्ड बुक दिस इज माय स्टैंडर्ड बुक सो एवरीबडी सेज ही स्वेयर्स बाय हिज ओन बुक सो दट इज वाई श्रुतयः विभिन्नाः देन नैको ऋषिर्यस्य मतं प्रमाणं देर इज नॉट ए सिंगल ऋषि हूज मतं कैन बी टेकन एज प्रमाणं एवरीबडी सेज नो नो मै मतं इज करेक्ट नैको ऋषिर्यस्य मतं प्रमाणं धर्मस्य तत्त्वं निहितं गुहायां दि एसेंस ऑफ धर्म इज इन युवर ओन हार्ट दट इज एवरीबडी इन हिज ओन हार्ट ऑफ हार्ट्स एज वी से इन अवर ओन हार्ट ऑफ हार्ट वी नो वाट इज धर्म एंड वाट इज अधर्म while doing any act while doing anything you see you know that what you are doing is right or what you are doing is wrong so that is you know in your own heart of hearts you know what is dharma what is adharma that is known to everybody not only a pandit not only a scholar even an ordinary man even an uneducated man knows what is right and what is wrong in fact that is what we call conscience in fact this gayatri mantra धियो वट इज दट श्लोक विशेष धियो धर्मादिगोचरा यो देवः सवितास्माकं धियो धर्मादिगोचरा प्रेरयेत् तस्य यद्भर्गस्तद्वरेण्यम् उपासमहे दट इज एक्सप्लेनेटरी मंत्र दट इज एक्सप्लेनेटरी श्लोक फॉर गायत्री मंत्र ऑफ कोर्स धियो यौवन प्रचोदया दट इज देर इज एन एक्सप्लेनेटरी श्लोक बिलो दट वट इज दट यो देवः सवितास्माकं धियो धर्मादिगोचरा प्रेरयेत् That is that divine thing, which is which in our own hearts, which is revealing what is right and what is wrong. Dhiyaha dharmaadi gocharaha. All this dharma and adharma is being revealed to us. So that means even a thief knows, a thief, suppose when does he go for, say, his thieving? He goes when nobody is there in the house, or sometime in the night, in the dead of the night when everybody is sleeping, he tries to go and steal. So even by doing a wrong thing also, he knows that he is doing a wrong thing. So that is why he is going in the night, otherwise he can as well go openly and then he can take away the articles. He will not do like that. So that is the meaning here. So Mahajano Yena Gatasya Pantha. Mahajanaha Yena Gataha. That is a great man. Whatever is the path, say trodden by a great man, that is the path to be followed. So that is what Dharmaraja says. So like that, Yadyad Acharati Sreshtaha Tattadeva Itarojanaha. He becomes the role model for all others. Sreshtaha Yat Pramanam Kurute Laukikam Vaidikam Va. Laukikam Vaidikam Va. This Vaidikam word also, it is significant in the sense, suppose you are supposed to do certain Vaidika karmas and you give up saying that it is all trash, then the other man who is seeing you, he will also follow. If you do not do Sandhyavandan, your son will not do Sandhyavandan. So leave alone Yajna, Yaga and what not. If you do not perform Sandhyavandan in your house, your own son will not perform Sandhyavandan. So Vaidikam Karma, Vaidikam Va Lokaha Tat Anuvartate Tadeva Pramani Karoti. Over a period of time, that becomes a standard behavior. The standard behavior falls from day to day, day by day, it keeps on changing. Because there is a lot of social change which is there. And then say, in spite of social change, there are certain things to be preserved. There are certain things to be learnt from social change. Social change is not bad. Nobody can stop change. And so from social change, we have to adapt to social change. So that is the point here. Then next shloka, is the time over?
3 minutes.
3 minutes. Then let me read the next shloka. Yadi yatra. Te. लोकसंग्रह कर्तव्यतायां विप्रतिपत्तिः तर्हि माम किं न पश्यसि. सो मे बी अर्जुनास बॉडी लैंग्वेज से वाज रादर आई मीन नॉट वेरी कंफर्टेबल फॉर कृष्णा बिकॉज अर्जुना वाज स्टिल लुकिंग रादर डिफाइंट प्रोबब्ली. सो दैट इज वाई कृष्णा इज अगेन सेइंग यदि अत्र ते लोकसंग्रह कर्तव्यतायां विप्रतिपत्ति. इफ यू स्टिल डिस्प्यूट, इफ यू आर नॉट स्टिल कन्विंस्ड अबाउट दिस नीड फॉर दिस लोकसंग्रह, इफ यू फील, इफ यू आर स्टिल नॉट कन्विंस्ड, विप्रतिपत्ति मीन्स डिफरेंस ऑफ ओपिनियन. इफ यू आर स्टिल हैविंग सम सॉर्ट ऑफ डिफरेंस ऑफ ओपिनियन अबाउट दिस लोकसंग्रह, देन यू लुक एट मी. दैट इज वॉट ही इज सेइंग. सो मे बी अर्जुनास बॉडी लैंग्वेज वॉज नॉट आई मीन इंप्रेसिव टू कृष्णा. So that is why he is saying, you seem to be entertaining some doubts, you still seem to be having some of your own ideas about why you have to do this karma, you look at me. So that is what he is saying. Yadi atra, if here, te to you, lokasangraha kartavyatayam, that is the need to do your karma for the sake of lokasangraha. Lokasangraha kartavyata, kartavyata means the need to do, the necessity of this lokasangraha. Vipratipattihi. Vipratipatti means difference of opinion. If it is there, tarhi. Tarhi means in that case, maam kim na pashyasi. Why don't you look at me? Why don't you see my example? Then this shloka, let us read this shloka. Name parthasti kartavyam. Trishu lokeshu kinchana. Na anavaptam avaptavyam. वर्तयेव च कर्मणि. सो न मे पार्थ अस्ति कर्तव्यं त्रिषु लोकेषु किंचन. वर्ड्स आर वेरी वेरी सिंपल. हे पार्थ, पार्थ इज द एड्रेस. हे पार्थ, न मे अस्ति कर्तव्यं त्रिषु लोकेषु किंचन. इन ऑल द थ्री वर्ड्स ऐ डोंट हैव एनीथिंग टू डू. दट ईज देर इज नो ऑब्लिगेशन ऑन मी टू डू एनीथिंग. न मे पार्थ अस्ति कर्तव्यं मीन्स there is no duty. Kartavyam is something which is an essential duty for me in the three lokas. Na anavaptam, something which has not been attained by me. If I have to do a karma, if there is something which is not attained by me, or which there is something which has to be attained by me. Suppose I don't have a pen, I have to go and look for a pen. Then I don't have something else, I have to go and look for something. Na anavaptam means that which I don't have. That means I have everything. अवाप्तव्यम, देर इज नथिंग विच आई हैव टू अक्वायर फ्रॉम आउटसाइड, देर इज नथिंग विच आई हैव टू गेट फ्रॉम आउटसाइड, बट वर्त एव च कर्मणि, आई एम एंगेज्ड, वर्त एव, वर्त मीन्स वर्ते, दट इन संधि, दट ए goes and then varta only remains. Varta means aham varte, karma, aham karmani varte, that is the line. Varte in that shloka, when sandhi comes, varta eva, it becomes like that. Varte, aham karmani varte, I am always engaged in karma. So that is the meaning here. Name partha asti kartavyam, trishu lokeshu kinchana. Kinchana means even a little bit. Even a little bit karma, there is no obligation on me. Then na anavaptam, avaptavyam, there is nothing which I don't have, nothing which I seek from outside, but still I am doing this karma. I think we will do in the next class, because we have to see why there is no duty to karma. I am sorry, no, why there is no duty in the case of Krishna, because Krishna, we know that he is an avatara purusha. So what is an avatara and what is the difference between an ordinary person and an avatara purusha? Then avatara purusha, does he have any duty? So there is some small explanation given by some people. So I think we'll read it in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.